President Obama sat down with congressional leaders of both parties for lunch Friday at the White House. Over sea bass and pumpkin tart, they discussed the way forward with the Republicans soon to control Congress. And they disagreed sharply over the president's plan for executive action on immigration. Joining us now, two of the leaders who were there. Senator John Barrasso is chair of the Senate Republican Policy Committee. And Congressman Javier Becerra is head of the House Democratic Caucus. Gentlemen, welcome back to Fox News Sunday. Before we get to the White House lunch, I want to ask you about the president's decision on Friday to send 1,500 more U.S. troops to Iraq, almost doubling our deployment there. Senator Barrasso, you're on the Foreign Relations Committee. A couple of questions. One, are you going to vote for the $5.6 billion in extra money the president wants? And secondly, how do you feel about this slow motion, bit by bit escalation of our footprint in Iraq?
Yeah, we're going to look at specifically how he wants the money spent, but it's right that the president does come to Congress for an authorization of the use of military force. I support that. I think Congress ought to be involved in those discussions. You do get concerned about a mission creep. I think they've been doing a good job in terms of trying to degrade, but they have a long way to go in terms of destroying ISIS and trying to secure Iraq. There are still big problems in Syria, and we just discussed all of this with General Austin on Friday at the White House, as well as the Secretary of Defense.
Congressman Becerra, any concerns that this escalation has the scent of Vietnam about it? And do you think the president has a strategy and a plan to beat ISIS?
The way it was outlined at the lunch on Friday, it seemed like a pretty coherent plan that was directed at the ultimate goal of dismantling ISIL. And my sense is this, after, as Senator said, we have an opportunity to look closely at all the details, I think most members are going to see that this is just a buildup of the original plan, which is to try to help the Iraqis stand up and take care of business.
But where does it end? We're talking about it was in the 200, now it's 2,900. How many more U.S. troops?
I think the president has always said that the Iraqis have to handle this. We're going to help them. They've asked for the help. We're willing to help, but it's their job to take care of their civil war. And so I don't think the president intends to have this become anything close to Vietnam.
Okay. Let's talk about the lunch, which you both attended on Friday. Senator Barrasso, how heated was the discussion about the president taking executive action to defer deportations of millions of people in this country illegally? And will that really, as some Republican leaders are suggesting, hurt cooperation on every issue?
Well, I believe it will hurt cooperation on every issue, Chris. What the president does over the next 2 months is really going to set the tone for the next 2 years in Washington. You know, nobody ran for office and won a Senate race based on the president having more executive authority to take executive actions on amnesty or on health care or any other of those issues. The American people want us to work together to find solutions. So I think it'd be like the president pulling the pin out of the hand grenade and throwing it in as we're trying to actually work together. I'm hoping that cooler heads at the White House can prevail upon the president to say, look, if you want to have a good, constructive final 2 years of your presidency, don't do this now. Wait until the new Congress is sworn in. Let them come together and do the sort of things that Senator-elect Gardner was talking about in terms of working together to find some solutions on immigration.
Congressman, a couple of questions for you. Did the president really cut off Vice President Biden when he started talking about this, the idea of how long would it take Republicans to come up with their own bill? And do you worry that it's going to be the grenade scenario and that this is going to poison the well on a bunch of issues, not just immigration?
Well, first, I don't recall anybody being cut off. There was a good conversation back and forth. And on the issue of immigration and where we'll go, I think the president has been very patient. He made it very clear quite some time ago. He's been waiting for 6 years to get a bill from Congress. He's been waiting a year and a half for the House Republicans to act on the bill that the Senate passed on a bipartisan basis. And the president for months has been saying he's going to take action where he can to try to make the law work better, smarter than what it is right now. And so I don't think there's anything strange going on here, except for the fact that if House Republicans continue to insist that the president must wait to help fix what everyone agrees is a broken immigration system, the only thing that is harmed is our security, our economy, and all those families that are waiting to see some results. So I think the president is right to move forward, to do what President Reagan, President Bush Sr., President Bush Jr., President Clinton. All presidents have used executive orders to try to make the laws work better. He cannot change the law. He can only try to make it work better and smarter.
Senator Barrasso, you say the president, this was your quote the other day, still hasn't come to grips with this election. Do you think he's in denial?
I don't know that, but he is sure, I think, not fully grasping the significant defeat for his party and his policies. As the president said, his policies were on the ballot, each and every one of them. We have now elected, I think we will end up with 9 new Republican senators. His policies have been rejected by the voters, and not just because they're unpopular, but because they don't work. And that's why we went to the White House to say, Mr. President, we want to work with you on issues of jobs, the economy, affordable energy, and health care. And I was astonished that during that whole lunch, the president didn't ask us anything about that at all. He just was so focused on this executive amnesty issue that he ignored the idea of having a dialogue on ways we could actually change the direction of the country and move forward with regard to jobs and the economy.
Is that true?
Let me disagree with the senator. The president wasn't so focused on the issue of executive action until Speaker Boehner was the one that raised it, saying it's going to be tough to do anything together if you do executive action. Then that's when the president tried to respond back. So to put the blame on the president for responding to the speaker, I think, is unfair. The president said, we've got a lot to do together. We got to deal with...
Was there not a discussion back and forth about both parties' ideas about jobs?
That was, the president posed that as one of the issues that we should have conversation about. Remember, we had only so much time to discuss a number of issues. We had a briefing by the military on the situation in Syria and Iraq. And so, as the president said, he went through about 4 or 5 different issues and said, all these issues I hope we have an opportunity to work with
Senator Barrasso, you think there wasn't enough talk about the economy and jobs, which is, according to voters, the number one concern?
But if there wasn't, whose fault is it that we didn't discuss the economy more? It was John Boehner who said, started off right away, executive action, it's going to be tough to do anything.
Well, the president then spent an inordinate amount of time talking about his goals for executive action and pretty much ignored the next 2 years. And that's why I say what the president decides to do in the next 2 months sets the tone for the next 2 years. There are dozens of bills that have passed the House in a bipartisan way, specifically related to jobs, the economy, trade, healthcare, that we want to put and will start putting on the president's desk in January. None of those issues came up. It seems that in addition to the Ebola and the ISIS briefings, that a lot of the focus was the president's goal and desire to take executive actions when the president's policies and party were repudiated in the elections on Tuesday.
Congressman Becerra, the president said the day after the election that one of the big changes is that Republicans will no longer have to kowtow to the Tea Party wing in the House and the Senate, but especially the House. Here's what he said.
It means that negotiations end up perhaps being a little more real because they have larger majorities, for example, in the House, and they may be able to get some things through their caucuses that they couldn't before.
Congressman, do Democrats have to do anything differently?
Well, all of us have to do something differently.
Well, I'm asking about Democrats.
Yeah, Democrats and Republicans.
What do Democrats have to do differently?
I think Democrats have to know that now that the Senate and the House are both in the hands of Republicans, that we're going to have to see where we can work with those that drive the agenda in the House and the Senate to see where we can come together and find common ground. It's no longer going to be a Republican House working with a Democratic Senate. And so it's going to be one of those areas where we have to see if we can join with Republicans as they propose legislation to send to the president. And hopefully the Republicans in both the House and the Senate propose bills that the president has said he's willing to sign versus just send him legislation that he said, this is going to be vetoed as soon as it gets to my desk.
Finally, Senator Barrasso, and I want to ask you a question that I asked Senator-elect Capito. How do you feel about the president trying to get the confirmation of Loretta Lynch as the new attorney general to get her confirmed in this lame duck session as opposed to waiting for the new Senate? And how much will you resist it if he tries to get her confirmed in this session?
The attorney general of the United States is a very consequential position. We have not done an attorney general confirmation in a lame duck since 1906, and that was in the same party. The last time we've done one with a change of party was when James Buchanan was leaving the White House and Abraham Lincoln was coming in. So as I say, what the president does in 2 months is very consequential for the next 2 years. She is going to have to specifically come to the Hill, talk about trying to get better relations between the departments and the Hill, and specifically answer questions about executive amnesty. Is it legal? Is it constitutional?
Senator Barrasso, Congressman Becerra, thank you both. Thanks for joining us today.
Thank you.
We can solve one of the mysteries about the lunch. Let's show you a picture of the leaders of Congress as they left the lunch. And you can see they were carrying swag bags, White House swag bags from the lunch. We wondered what was in the swag bags. Well, John Barrasso has given me, and I think I may drink it in the second half of the show, White House honey ale. So what did you get, a six-pack or a
six-pack
of White House honey ale? Have you tried it?
No, not yet.
You tried it?
Not yet. Will, though.
Well, maybe we'll have a beer summit.
Let's do it.
There you go. Thank you, gentlemen.
Thank you.
Always a pleasure. We'll be watching what happens on Capitol Hill.